Yeah, it's such a privilege and honor to be here and to share God's word again. First of all, I want to give glory and honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And also Pastor Joshua Murray La'ang for having invited me to share God's word with you today. And we want to thank you also the leadership team here and also each one of you. I really enjoyed that theme song you just sang, Standing on the Word of God, right? Standing on the Rock. Praise the Lord. We both enjoyed really, not as a performance, but standing and acting it out.
Amen.
You know, in Rhema, when I conduct the exam sometime, I used to say this. I would say, exam will be very easy, provided you paid attention. Then I will say, exam actually is not for today, but for life. You can get 100% of 100%, but in life, it has to mean something to you. So let's not be just hearers of God's word, but also doers of God's word. Father, help us to see the way we need to see today. Open our hearts and also our minds so that we can be receptive to your word. Your word is food, we are hungry for it. Your word is living water, we are thirsty for it. Feed us and also fill us our thirst that we will be able to be receiving from you as a fresh manna from
him.
We want to give you glory because, Father God, everywhere we preach the word of God, you will follow or you will confirm the signs following.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Today I want to talk about how to fulfill your destiny. First of all, it is your church anniversary. And this word would be very appropriate. As a word of life family center, what is your call and what is going to be your destiny?
Word of life family center,
the church is made of families and individuals. So as we follow our destiny individually and family, then the church family will follow God's course. Now, Psalms 32 and verse 8, I want you to see in your Bibles. Let me read it in King James Version. I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way which thou shalt go. I will guide thee with my eye.
Tengo na tonte mi, ten toaya ni lango piano mi, tengo chishu yusu mi, nyan piya meto, nyan la kero machine.
Whenever you read the word of God, you must see the context in which this particular verse appears. When David is repenting before God after committing adultery with Bathsheba, this particular psalm is written. As he was talking to the Lord about the matter and committing his life back and coming to a place of repentance, suddenly the Lord starts to speak.
So tu ye atatare ma tu atishne khama sne yure khama khansa ya re bacha mo re sure khama tu ba ye mya tu che ma ti re khama tu me khansa bi ma sait tat tat sait an nge re khama phaya tikin tan nong da ya chin ne tou win ne khama phaya ga di saka ko tu ko pe da phit ba re.
In first verse 32:1 it says, blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. And he is bringing back to his remembrance and repenting before God.
So Payadikina tu ye atata atenema, tu apiale dima kosaunare tu ye nodaya chile yogare kama payanka pyale dima tu ye achili wutale pitya.
In verse 7 he says this. Thou art my hiding place, thou shalt preserve me from trouble, thou shalt compass of me about with songs of deliverance. As he was pouring his heart out to the Lord, suddenly the Lord started to speak. And he's saying in verse 8, I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way which thou shalt go. I will guide thee with mine eye.
And he said, Tu ye nalonda ga ni phaya shi mau ma phwin pya de akha ma tin go nga twin tin mi tin twa ya mi lan go pya nyu mi.
Who is speaking here? God Himself speaks. Whenever you read what God says, pay attention. I will instruct thee. I will teach thee. I will lead you in the way you should go. I will guide you with my eye.
မင်းဘယ်လိုတွားရမလဲဆိုတဲ့လမ်းခီးပေါ်တဲ့ငါမျက်စိကနေမှမင်းတွားရမယ်ဆိုတာကပြန့်ညင်ပြီးတ
ယ် If you read this particular verse and understand it
တကယ်တမ်းကျွန်တော်တို့ဒီနှုတ်ကပတ်တော်ကိုဖတ်တဲ့အခါမှာတိတိကျကျသဘောပေါက်နားလည်နိုင်မှာဖြစ်ပါတယ
် God has a purpose
အဲ့ဒီချိန်မှာဘာတွေ့ရလဲဆိုဖခင်ရဲ့ရည်ရွယ်ချက်ရှိတယ
် For your life
ကျွန်တော်တို့တယောက်ချင်းစီတိုင်းအတွက်ဖြစ်တယ
် And God is interested in your lifeGod is going to keep his eye upon you. He's going to lead you. He's going to guide you. He's going to instruct you. How is he going to do? With his eyes. This is talking about relationship. Let me give you some illustration for you to understand. You know, parents and children can talk with their eyes.They don't need to say a lot of words. You know, when parents look at the children with one eye, one kind of look, they will understand, they will obey. You know, between husband and wife,They can communicate without even speaking. It goes just by looking. Do you understand what I'm saying? You see, I can speak now with my wife, you will not even know it just by my eyes.
ကျွန်တော်အနေနဲ့ကျွန်တော်စကားပြောစရာတော့ကျွန်မျက်စိနဲ့ပြောတာလေးကိုမင်းတို့တဘောပေါက်တယ
် We are married now 33 years you see 33 years we are married
Okay ကျွန်တော်တို့လက်ထက်က33နှစ်ရှိပြီ
These relationships make easy for the eye contact
Any relationship 33နှစ်ထဲမှာတဲ့မျက်စိနဲ့ပဲကျွန်တော်အနေနဲ့တဲ့ကျွန်တော်ဇနီးတဲ့ကိုစစ်စစ်လားတ
Let me tell you how many of you understand what I'm talking about. So basically here it's talking about your relationship with God. And when God says, I will, and I will,
ဖယားကပြောလေဆိုတော့ငါလုပ်ပေးမယ်ငါလုပ်ပေးမယ်ငါချစ်ရှုပေးမယ်ဆိုခဏခဏပြောနေ
Then suddenly in verse 9 he says this
တဲ့ယုံကြည်အပိုက်ကြီးကိုရောက်လာတဲ့အခါကျတော့
Be ye not as the horse or as the mule which have no understanding whose mouth must be held in with bit and bridle lest they come near unto thee
ပင်ရဲ့ကိုမပါပြောလဲဆိုတူဒီတဲ့သင်္ချံတို့မချင်းကတ်တော့ကြောင့်ပစက်ကိုစစ်ခွင်နဲ့စစ်ချိုးနဲ့ဆွဲရတယ
် Suddenly this word changes God changes the tone here
ရုပ်တည်းအိမ်ဟာပြောတဲ့စကားကပြောင်းလဲမှုဖြစ်သွားတယ်အရှိမကူတကူအခုကိုရောက်လာတဲ့အခါကျတော့သူ့ရဲ့စကားပြောပုံကပြောင်းသွားတယ်ဗျာ
In verse 8 he said I will lead you I will instruct you I will guide you I will show youSuddenly, he says, don't be like a horse or a mule. Suddenly, he says, don't be like an animal. Because animals will have to be controlled.
ဘာကြောင့်လဲဆိုတဲ့အခါမှာတိရစ္ဆာန်ဆိုတာကထိချုပ်ရတယ်
Horse will not come near you. It has to be put on bit and bridle to true towards me. If you don't put a bit of bridle or pull it, just go on, it's very, very fast. Mule will not go fast. Mule is always very slow. You have to tight and pull, then only it'll come near. Horse needs to be pulled, the mule needs to be kicked. Correct. So God says, don't be like an animal. Don't just go wherever you want to run and be slow when God is speaking. Then he says, I will guide you. I will instruct you. I will teach you. I will be your instructor. Personal instructor. Exactly. God says, I myself will be an instructor. How am I going to lead? I'm going to lead by my eyes. So if you need guidance, where should your eyes be fixed? Our eyes must be fixed to our teacher. Our eyes must be fixed to our teacher. Our eyes must be fixed upon him so that you will watch his eyes. I don't know whether you understand this, but this goes across cross culture. You can speak with your eyes. It is all based on your relationship. So God is interested in your life. He initiates. I will instruct you. So why is he God very much interested in our lives? Because he has a plan for your life. Every other plan is less than God's plan. You can do a lot of good things, but it may not be God things. You can be doing a lot of good things with good attitudes, but may not be God things with God's attitude. Many people think that what they are doing is God things, but they may not be God things just because they are good.
The
So why not we follow God's plan? Do you mean to say that God has a specific plan for my life? You may say to me, well, you are a minister, God may have a call for you, but what about me? Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 10. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. Now, this in an amplified English version gives you further light. Let me read it for you, and Paslang will tell in Myanmarese for you to easily understand. We may do those good works which God predestined, pre-planned, that is beforehand, for us to take in path which he prepared ahead for us. Wow.
Yes.
So today I'm going to show you very simple ways in which you can be guided by the Holy Spirit. You can be guided by God Himself. Fundamentally, first thing is that God always leads you by His word. Matthew chapter 4 verse 4. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. God wants us to live basically by the word of God. We are such a privileged people to have the word of God in your hands, in my hands, in our gadgets, we have in our Bibles, we have the word of God right in our palms. We need to go by the word of God. Many times we get into trouble when we do not follow the written word of God. Once you see the word of God, you just trust it. Because it is God who is speaking. So the one who has called you is interested in you. So every one of us has a plan God has already gone before us and provided for. How are you going to fulfill that God's purpose and plans for your life? It can be only possible by following Him. It can only be seen by our eyes, with these eyes fixed together, we will be able to follow His path. Proverbs 3, verse 5 and 6 says this. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him and He shall direct your path. So basically we are following the written word of God. The word of God is a book of instructions. The word of God is our guide. Do you know the only difference between other books and the Bible? I'll show you what's the difference. This is the only book where the author is with you to guide. So when you're reading the word of God, Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Truth will be speaking to you from within you. You see, 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 11, let me read for you, you will understand what I'm talking about. First Corinthians chapter 10 verse 11. Now all these things happen unto them for examples, that they are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world are come. Even the Bible, the illustrations that you read, the examples you read, the word of God says these are given for our admonition. Do you know what the word admonition there means? Literally it means I will give you slap. You know, it's not to harm you, but to get your attention.
Attention.
You know, nowadays, I see a lot of things that comes to husband-wife relationships. You know, relationships between husband and wife.
Yes.
They don't follow the word of God, they get into trouble.
So,
do you know what they do? They walk their own ways. Only if they can follow the word of truth. Only if they have sense to understand God's word. They would not walk their own ways. They can always get counsel from the word of God. For those people who are not yet married, this would be a good time to spend time with the word of God so that you will be guided in the right way. You see, before I got married, I know that this is the woman I need to get married to. Honestly, I never even saw her before marriage. Never spoke a word also before marriage.
Before marriage. Okay.
Never dated also. All the things are not wrong. I didn't say that. But I know I am following God. In reality, I agreed to marry her without even seeing her. Now she is seeing at me, she is passing me something. She is telling me. She's telling me, tell about me also, tell about me. Am I right? She also made the same commitment to God. God spoke to her separately, God spoke to me separately. Today we are able to walk through what God has planned for our life because we honor God's word concerning marriage.
Amen.
Thank God we are not like horse and mule. One go faster, one go slower.
Hallelujah.
Thank God. Amen. Going hand in hand with God. So basically, number one thing that we need to go just by the word of God. Can I say in another way? If you just follow and obey the Lord with God's word, you are actually obeying Him. You will not miss God for your life or nor God's plan for your life. Okay, number two.
Okay, number two.
How can you follow His plan for your life? God always leads His children by His peace. God always leads His children by His peace. Sometimes you may not have specific word of God concerning your situation. Like which job I need to do, what career, which person I need to marry, all those things. There is no specific chapter and verse for it. But when you are obedient to God's word, Then when you come to a place where it is not very clear concerning your life, there comes His peace. He will give you peace. When you follow His path, there shall be such shalom inside you. But if you go other ways, then you will lose that peace. Go with the Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3. And verse 15, it says this. Let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you were called in one body, and ye be thankful. Let the peace of God rule in your hearts. Recently, I had something to write to somebody in an email. It's a good thought. It's a good thing that I wanted to do. I typed it out. I could not send it. I want to go to send button. Suddenly I sense my peace is lost. It is not my peace, I have to say it rightly, it is God's peace inside me. After one day, again I went to the email. I want to send it. When I was about to send it, suddenly I sense that peace of God leaves me. When I don't do it, I still sense that peace of God. So the peace of God will act like an umpire, you know, in a match. It's a referee, it's an umpire.
Okay. So
if you say, Lord, can I do it? Then the umpire will say, yes, go ahead. Or the umpire will say, no, right?
So,
yes or no.
Yes.
So whenever you make such decisions, look on the inside. If there is presence of peace, you may proceed. If there is no presence of peace, you are not supposed to proceed. First, I said he leads us by his word. Number two, he leads us by his peace. Third, he leads us by desire. God's desire putting inside you as if it is your desire. Watch it carefully. God's desire, He's going to put in your heart as if it is your desire. You may think it is your desire, but actually it's not your desire. It is God putting His desire in you. I'll tell you when this will happen. When you are intended to always want to do the word of God, you purpose in your heart to look for the peace of God, then you will sense that the desires of God He will put inside you.
So,
now read this one, it will be very interesting for you to see. Acts chapter 7 verse
23.
Acts chapter
7:23.
It is talking about Moses. What a wonderful man of God that fulfilled plan of God in his life, right? Just see this particular verse. And when Moses was full 40 years old, it came into his heart to visit his brethren, the children of Israel. Here can you see, Moses is not with Israel people now. You remember, he ran away. When he was 40 years old, the word of God says, it came to into his heart to visit his brethren in the children of Israel. Suddenly there is a desire coming into Moses for looking for his own brethren. What happened? All these years there was no desire? Exactly when he hit years 40, suddenly there is a desire that he must go and see his brother.
Okay.
Who gave this desire? It looks like as if Moses had a desire. Now you read this particular verse. Philippians chapter 2 and verse
13. 2 and 1, 3.
See, for it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do His good pleasure. That means God puts His desire inside you and makes as if it is your own desire. Did you hear? Sometimes it may be your own desire. You know how you can detect that? It may not be in agreement to God's word. It may be all with your fleshly interest. But if you are intended already, you have plan and purpose in your heart, God, you guide me and take God's word serious and always go by the peace of God, I'll tell you, your desire is God who puts inside you. So God works in you and puts a desire in you so that you think it is your desire, but it's not yours. Did you receive that?
Yeah.
I'm showing in a way that you can receive it. Follow the word. Follow the peace. Follow the desire. One more I'll tell you. Following your own spirit. Your spirit is God's guide within you. Really, let me shortly show you this particular scripture and we wind up. Romans chapter 9, verse 1. Romans chapter 9 and verse
1.
I say the truth in Christ, I lie not, my conscience also bearing me witness in the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Can you see that? How your spirit follows the witness of the Holy Spirit. Your spirit bears witness with the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost giving instruction to your spirit. Your spirit will know things from the Holy Spirit. So when you follow the word, you get direction. Pay attention to the peace of God that is within you. Check concerning the desires that comes into your spirit. Follow the witness of your spirit. When the Holy Spirit is speaking, within you, you will have that spirit of yours speaking to you. And it is actually picking up from the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
You need to follow all these principles and you will find you will always follow God's plan. So God says to you today, I will instruct you. I will lead you. I will teach you. I will guide you. With my own eyes, I will do that. But do not be like a horse. Nor like a mule. Don't go faster. Don't go slower. Walk with me. Walk with me. I will show you. I will bring you to the intended end. He has a good plan for your life. Plan to prosper you. And to bring you to the end. That's what Jeremiah 29:11 says. Let's close our eyes. I believe the Lord has spoken to you. The Lord has spoken to me as well. I believe the Lord has spoken to every one of us here. Let's follow His word. Let's follow His peace. Let's follow His desire within us. Let's yield to the Holy Spirit when He speaks to our spirit. This means you are standing on the rock of God's word. That means you stay firm. As individually you follow God's will, as a family you will fulfill God's will, and as a church you will be able to fulfill God's plan. Would you just make a commitment just for a moment? Just make a commitment and say, Lord, I want to follow you.
Today,
Father, I commit all these dear ones who have given their hearts as a commitment to you, and you will honor their commitment. All glory, all honor belongs to you and you alone. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.